Last summer, I had an idea to make a jumping robot, and that's why I built this mechanism. It uses two springs which can be compressed and later released to create sort of a jump movement. And it was supposed to be mounted in a robot chassis similar to that of the Parrot jumping sumo drone, but it turned out to be way too weak for any practical use. And that's why I kinda forgot about this project. However, since the release, my video about this mechanism got quite popular on my channel, and some of you wanted to see the future development of the jumping robot. And to be honest, I still love the idea of building something similar to my childhood dream toy, so I guess it's time for part 2. Alright, so first let's take a quick look at this old prototype. Here at the top we have a small DC motor with a tiny gearbox. Of course, this motor couldn't compress those two springs by itself, so I designed a second 3D printed gearbox that greatly increases the output torque and is also painfully slow. All of that torque goes right into this big pinion gear, which as you can see has only 5 teeth on each side. So when it slowly rotates, the rack goes along with it, which causes the springs to compress. And when there are no more teeth to engage, this happens. So basically this whole thing works pretty much the same as an electric airsoft gun, except it doesn't shoot pellets, but rather itself. But overall, this design has some serious flaws, like for example this gear was too weak and it broke, so I had to print another one. Also, as I said before, it is too slow and not powerful enough to jump, which makes it pretty much useless. Okay, so how can we make it better? Well, the most important things that we need to replace are those springs, because they simply don't have enough power. And if we take a look at the jumping sumo robot, we can see that its own springs are much longer. So I did some research, and since our mechanism works like an airsoft gun, I bought, no surprise here, airsoft springs. These are not the strongest on the market, but we are going to use both of them, so that should give us a lot of power. Now we also need a stronger motor to compress those springs. And I think that I will just take this servo and modify it for continuous rotation, so that we can use it as a high torque motor. Another thing we need is a lightweight, but at the same time rigid frame. And that's why I made a trip to my local construction store to buy some thin aluminium pipes, which we can later attach to the 3D printed parts. Okay, so now when we know what we are working with, let's design the new, better jump mechanism. Right, so here we have the 3D model of our old prototype. And now, that's the new version. First thing that you might notice is that this mechanism is obviously a little bit larger, because those new springs are like 2.5 times longer. But overall, I try to keep this design quite compact and also lightweight. Those aluminium pipes that I was talking about before are used here as a linear guides for the springs, because they bend a lot and that way you can keep them straight. Another important design change is that the gearbox reduction is now much lower, since the servo already has a quite high torque. And thanks to that, spring compression will be now significantly faster. Talking about the gearbox, all the gears are now changed from spur gears to herringbone gears. And if you don't know why that's a good thing, check out my last video where I talked a lot about gears. But in short, they are stronger, they run smoother, and most important of all, they look much better. Other than those few design changes, there isn't really a lot to talk about, since the working principle of those two mechanisms is exactly the same. So enough talking, let's build this thing. Okay, so it seems that we have a small problem here. It looks like the servo mount is too flexible, which causes the gears to skip. And that is actually a quite serious design flaw, but I may have an easy fix for it. So I opened Fusion 360 again and I designed this tiny part that should keep both gears tied together. And luckily, when I mounted it in place, it fixed the skipping problem. But it's just a temporary solution for now. Alright, now when we finally got it working, it's time to test what this thing can really do. So here we are in my garden, where I just hammered a metal pipe into the ground, but I'm going to call this a test rig. I also added this 3D printed ring to our test subject, so that it can slide on the pipe and jump straight up. Now let's see it in action. Well, that was disappointing. Although the mechanism had plenty of power, it was constantly getting stopped on the pipe. So it turns out that this test rig was just a dumb idea. And that's why at this point I decided to just give up on testing and jump right into building the rest of the robot. So, we have the main jump mechanism, but that is just one part of the whole robot. Now we need to give it a drive system. The motors I'm going to use for this purpose are those small N20 micro-geared motors, because they are quite strong and also I have already used them in previous version. And to attach them I designed those two motor mounts. They also have a hole at the bottom for the wheel axle. Attaching wheels right to the motor shaft might have been a simpler and lighter solution, but that way the landing impact could easily damage the motor, which is something we obviously don't want. And speaking about wheels, they were the most tricky part to design, because they need to be very light and at the same time flexible to absorb the landing energy. And here is my take on them. Now I know that they don't really match the design overall look, but at least they should be very light. It of course would be much easier to design them if I had any flexible filament, but I only had PLA and 1-year-old PTG spool to choose from. PLA would probably break instantly, because it is too stiff, but PTG might actually survive. But before printing, I put my spool into the oven for a few hours at 80 degrees to get rid of all the moisture which caused me some printing problems in the past. And it might actually help, because those wheels printed very well. Next I assembled everything and went again to my garden. And as you can see, those wheels are actually quite flexible. So now when we have them, we can finally do some proper jump testing. While I was having some fun making the robot jump, I found out that we have a guest here. This big grasshopper came to check out his new mechanical counterpart. And apparently, he wasn't very happy with the idea of being replaced by the robots. Anyway, the wheels actually did a great job, because, well, they survived. Although, if it wasn't on grass, I think that they would break sooner or later. But so far, we have the main jump mechanism, we have a drive system, but we still need a way to control it. So it's time to add all the electronics to our robot. And here I have an Arduino Pro Mini, motor driver, RC receiver, step down voltage regulator, small relay and 2S LiPo battery. But at this point I realized that adding all those components will increase the weight of the robot, which is already too heavy. So to make it just a bit lighter, I redesigned the robot mainframe from a few separate pieces into one solid object, which helped to lose a few grams. Later I also unsoldered some pins and connectors to make it even lighter. And after that it was time to finally connect everything and test how it works. Okay, so now I only need to somehow attach it all to the robot chassis. I ended up using tape to mount all the components at the bottom of the robot. I also added those rings that compress the springs a bit more, which might give it some additional power. And at the back there is now a rubber feet, which should help with jumping on slippery surfaces. Finally, we can install the wheels, which by the way I upgraded by gluing some rubber pads to give it better traction. So now, when the robot is fully finished, let's try it out! Alright, so that project was a lot of fun, although it took me some time to finish it. And the robot itself is still far from perfect, but hey, it's quite an upgrade from the last video. And in the description, I'm giving you all the 3D files, schematics and Arduino codes. So if you want, you can make this robot and change it as you will. And if you manage to somehow make it better, please let me know in the comments. So that's all for now, thank you very much for watching and see you all in the next video.